ஆயிட்டே இருக்கும், ஜாஸ்தி ஆயிட்டே இருக்கும். இந்த செல்லு, செல் இஸ் த ஸ்மாலஸ்ட் பார்ட் ஆஃப் த பாடி. ஸோ இப்போ ஒரு நர்வ் செல் நியூரான்ன்றோம், நர்வ் செல் எஃபெக்ட் ஆச்சுன்னு நினைச்சுக்கோங்க, ப்ரோட்டீன் ஜாஸ்தி அக்யூமுலேட் ஆனால் அந்த நர்வ் செல் வில் டை. ஸோ சம் இந்த நியூரோடிஜெனரேட்டிவ் டிசார்டர்ல தீஸ் ஆர் ஆல்சோ கால்ட் ப்ரோட்டீனோபதி. Parkinson's disease la alpha synuclein ana ore protein na, it gets accumulated within these neurons. So when once they get accumulated within these neurons, they form something called as Lewy bodies. Ana adella apdi ore clump mari aipod ore ore gettiya aayi and the and the and the neuron kulla irunda it will prevent the movement of other important things which are has to happen in the it's like having ipo ore chatta kundi veetliye jaast aayinde irukku nenchukonga. I mean, if you have some garbage din, it will completely spoil your house. Adhe maradha the protein accumulate ii, it becomes, there is a breakdown of the neuron. So, and the neuron in the specific effect are the dopamine producing neuron. Dopamine on a chemical hormone produced from the neurons in the alpha synuclein and protein, JCI, those neurons die. So, if you see the render photo, the brown color la or line irukku illaya and the line da dopamine neurons adhe male irukra photo pathinga na and brown color line e illa edukana and the neurons ella settu pidu. So can we go to the next slide?
Okay,
so enna aguna ipo in the neuron ipo idu and the neurons damage ana dopamine and the neurons செத்து போனதுனால டோபமீன் ப்ரொடக்ஷன் குறைஞ்சு போகுது. பட் இது இது ரொம்ப சிம்பிள் சிம்பிளிஸ்டிக் வியூ. இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் கமிங் இன் வாட் இந்த சின்யூக்ளியன் அண்ட் ப்ரோட்டீன் இட் இஸ் நாட் ஜஸ்ட் ஸ்டார்டிங் இன் த பிரெயின், ப்ராபப்ளி இட் இஸ் ஸ்டார்டிங் இன் யுவர் இன்டெஸ்டைன். அந்த இன்டெஸ்டைன்லேருந்து ஒரு வேகஸ் நர்வ்னு இருக்கு, அந்த நர்வ் வந்து மேலே போய் ஸ்மால் பிரெயின் சொல்றோம் நாங்க, மெட்யூலா ஆப்லாங்கட்டா சின்ன பிரெயின். அந்த பிரெயின் கிட்டக்கு வந்து இட் கெட்ஸ் டிபாசிட். ஸோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் இன்டெஸ்டைனில் டிபாசிட் ஆகுது, அதுக்கப்புறம் அந்த நர்வையா போய் அந்த ஸ்மால் பிரெயின்ல எஃபெக்ட் ஆகுது, அதுக்கப்புறம் இட் கோஸ் டு த சப்ஸ்டான்ஷியல் நெக்ரா டோபமினர்ஜிக் ஏரியாக்கு போனதுக்கப்புறம் இட் இட் கெட்ஸ் அக்யூமுலேட்டட் இன் தோஸ் நியூரான்ஸ் அண்ட் தோஸ் நியூரான்ஸ் டை. ஸோ இட் இஸ் நாட் டைரக்ட்லி இன்வால்விங் ஒன்லி த டோபமினர்ஜிக் நியூரான். டோபிங் ப்ரொடக்ட் ப்ரொடியூஸ் பண்ணுற நியூரான்ஸ் ஒன்றுக்கு தான் எஃபெக்ட் பண்ணல, இட் ஆல்சோ ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ் எஃபெக்டிங் அதர் நியூரான்ஸ் அண்ட் இட் It begins with the involvement of other areas and then comes to the dopamine neurons. So enna aguna first initially because it starts in the gut and it goes to the vagal nerve and it starts in the brain stem, it produces lot of problems in them like constipation. Idella constipation la romba oru 10 varsham 15 varshathukku minnadiye start aagala ungalku Parkinson's disease theriyathukku minnadi. Constipation, sleep areas irukkadhu, so we call it as REM sleep behavioral disorder. Ana idu vandu thookathla kattaradhu, thookathla dream enactment idella minnadiye start aagalam ena because these are the areas which get affected before. Same similarly smell, loss of smell, in the mood effects are in the mood, it actually starts around few years before you develop tremor or stiffness or rigidity or the motor symptoms varthukku minnadi, because this is how the new the alpha synuclein goes up. Next slide. Next slide. So it will start anadukapram enna aguna. So once it comes to the dopaminergic neurons affect anona, you start developing features of Parkinson's disease. If you can click on the video, I'm not sure whether the video will play.
I don't think the video will play, doctor.
Okay, so the video, in the video lena, this is actually a lady who's this is what happens is ana being a tremor, stiffness, rigidity idella starter. So I'm sure everybody knows what is tremor. Tremor ana hand shake aagudhu. In the hand shaking can be in Parkinson's disease is very particularly at rest. எதுவும் பண்ணாத இருக்குச்சு, மாமலா உட்காந்துருக்குச்சு, இல்லைன்னா வாக்கிங் பண்றச்சு, ஏதாவது டீப்பா ஆலோசிச்சு இருக்குச்சு, ஷேக் ஆகும், ஹேண்ட் ஷேக்கிங். ஸோ இட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் ரெஸ்ட் ட்ரெமர். ஸோ இது ரொம்ப இம்பார்ட்டன்ட். ஏன்னா சில பேருக்கு தே வில் ஹேவ் ட்ரெமர் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் சோ மெனி அதர் ரீசன்ஸ். ஸோ ஆல் பீப்புள் ஹூ ஹேவ் ட்ரெமர் டஸ் நாட் டு நாட் ஹேவ் பார்க்கின்சன்ஸ் டிசீஸ். ஸோ இஃப் யூ ஹேவ் அ ரெஸ்ட் ட்ரெமர் விச் இஸ் டியூரிங் ரெஸ்ட், இட் இஸ் யூஸ்வலி பார்க்கின்சன்ஸ் டிசீஸ். ஒரு ஒரு கையில ஸ்டார்ட் ஆகும், it'll, after a few years, it can spread to the other hand. So this is the most common symptoms which is seen, which is called as a rest tremor. The other symptoms are actually felt by the patient rather than seen. So one, the second thing that happens is stiffness in the body. It's called as rigidity. In the stiffness, you're not able to move it freely. So this is usually not seen by the others, but it is felt by the patient themselves. Slowness in every activity. So everything becomes restricted. The reason being, dopaminergic neurons. Brain lane or a signal varanumanna kai kaalukku basically inga suppose inga inge nu naan ange inda or point A lane point B varaku naan nadakkare nenchikiren naan. So there will be a signal which will be sent from the brain where I will think, okay, inge naan ange varaku nadakkanumna or rendu nimisham nadakkanumna naan evlo speed la in the kaal evlo speed la kaal aatanum appo da and area ku poi naan nadakka mudiyum. So in the signal varra samayathile there is one, the area, the dopaminergic neuron area is called as a basal ganglion. The basal ganglion is actually the controller. It doesn't directly make the movement, but it is a controller. So it will decide, it will properly designate, okay, ivlo doorathukku pona ivlo amplitude edukano ivlo speed edukano, and it will give the signal to the spinal cord. Spinal cord lende it will come to your muscle. So in the area, in the basal ganglion area where the dopaminergic neurons are there, and the area and the controller ku signal varalena, the signal strength konji podu. Ipo naan pesindrukacha, my voice is coming down feebly because my signal strength is low. The same kind of thing happens if I so when the dopaminergic neurons are not there, the signal comes to the spinal cord and it does come to the muscle, but romba korava varudhu. It will come as a small signal, so in which case the movement will be small. So it is called as bradykinesia, so slower. So each step will be slow. Each inge ne kai eduthunde vaikilla vekkanumna the time taken will be very long. Kai vandu it will stop midway, so the person will bend down to eat. Idella every point la the amplitude of the movement comes down and the speed of the movement comes down. So this is called as bradykinesia. So in the most important aspects of Parkinson's disease, apart from that, you have balance issues. So sudden yaradhu turn panna sonna yaradhu pace sonna nadandu nikkacha suddenly there is a chance of falling. It's called as postural instability. Posture maintain pandrathukku you need very fast action. So because the brain is reacting so slowly, any kind of an abnormality in your gait, you tend to fall down. And then comes the bent posture. The bent posture is actually the least movement posture. And inga ipo straight ah nikkanona the muscle all should be acting very well, strong ah act pannu. So even physiotherapy la kuda that is what is one called as LSVT big brain solva, and the posture kuda improve pandrathukku, so that you have to have full range of movement. And the range enna konjinal person becomes bent, the hands come down to the side, the knees also get bent, they become small in general. So idella, these are the motor symptoms of Parkinson's disease. Next slide. You can go to the next slide also.
I think maybe this comes to a video also. Can I
video also we can skip it.
I think let us not elaborate too much on the symptoms. Members live with it. Even non-motor symptoms, do you want to touch upon them, doctor?
Just a brief mention, non-motor symptoms are if not just the motor problems, you can have non-motor problems. A non-motor problem is like psychiatric problem. Sometimes it can happen, maybe because of the disease, maybe because of the medication also. Adillaadhu, some people can have autonomic disturbances, which is more common. The jaasti sweating are the, sadanna sweating are the, sadanna hot are the, idella can happen. You can have things like BP sadanna drop are the nikkache. So these can happen. The third problem which can, these are all non-motor symptoms. As I told you, it is not just the dopaminergic neurons. The other parts of the brain are also involved, but to some extent. So we'll go to the next slide. So how do we diagnose it? There is no definitive diagnosis. But ippo enna we have something called as a TODAT scan, and scan pannala, and the TODAT scan la you can pick up whether there are டோபமின் லெவல்ஸ் குறைச்சலாம் இருக்கா என்ன இல்லையான். அதர்வைஸ் இட் இஸ் யூஸ்வலி த மெடிக்கல் ஹிஸ்டரி இங்க எக்ஸாமினேஷன் பார்த்துட்டு உங்களுக்கு பார்க்கின்சன்ஸ் டிசீஸ் இருக்கா இல்லையான்னு தெரியும். நெக்ஸ்ட் ஸ்லைட். Again, next slide. I think
yeah, I think you can say okay. If you go to
so now screen. For treatment current treatment is only symptomatic ana ipo ungalku thalaveli vandhadu nenchukonga or crocin potna thalaveli konjidum jwaram vandhadana again crocin potna and jwaram konjidum but jwarathukku reason ku treatment kadaiyadu. I mean it's not there in Parkinson's disease. So right now they're trying. There are a lot of medicines which are being tried and the alpha synuclein edukkathukku try panninduka mottamave edukkathukku try panninga. We are trying to have some vaccines for the medicines but they are not of much use. So currently what we have is symptomatic ana ipo dopamine release aayirukku dopamine korchala release aayirukku. So you want to give the dopamine to the brain, so you give medicines which will increase the dopamine levels in the brain. Next slide. So there is a search for cure but we still don't have it. Next slide. So in the dopamine kudukkuradhukku we need to give various kinds of medicines. Now in before we start with the therapy, dopamine anna padartham vandu it's there, it's a chemical, it's a hormone which is released in very various parts of the body. It is not just present in the brain, it's also present in the rest of the so
doctor there was
Parkinson's disease.
Can you repeat that? Dopamine is not present only in the brain but also
dopamine is not just present in the brain, it is present in the rest of the body. It is present in the GIT, I mean stomach. It is present in the blood, it's present in, it has some effects on the heart, it has, I mean, so it is not just present only in the brain. So in the brain la kuda dopamine anadhu, it's not just produced only in the brain, every part of the other parts of the body also produces dopamine. So what we need to realize is that in the Parkinson's disease is very selective disease. Ellarthum dopamine korikkadilla, it's not a universal reduction in dopamine. So dopamine is being produced in various parts of the body, it's produced in various parts of the brain, but in the brain la a selective substantia nigra area la da damage enter. So the area which controls the dopamine from which is required for the signal for movement to come from the brain to the spinal cord, and the area la da dopamine is becoming reduced, and the area neurons that is getting damaged. You suppose if I give an example, suppose you feel very happy, suppose you have won some lottery or you have won some you are dancing, you feel very happy and the dopamine is released in a different part of the brain called as limbic system, and that has got nothing to do with Parkinson's disease. That adu vandu normal ave release aayirukku. So you get the point is that dopamine is being released in the brain even in Parkinson's disease. It's also being released in the blood even in Parkinson's disease. Only one part of the brain the dopamine is not getting released. The reason why the part of the brain, the one that is released in the blood is not going into the brain, and dopamine in the blood gets broken down very fast. It doesn't cross the blood brain barrier avlo easya brain ku pohadu. Brain la kuda if you give dopamine, brain la kuda it's not like a idu vandu idu oru fluid mari irukadhu, neenga oru edathla potta ella edathilum seyra mari irukadhu. It is like say putting salt on laddu mela pottinga nenchu uppu or sugar, it will only stay on the surface. It is not like a liquid where it will, if you put it at one point it will continuously go through the whole brain. So for that to reach, so the dopamine kanga porathukku you need to give it in a different format. Ena ipo oru edathila potinga na that will get, it will just and edathila irukum and then the dopamine will get broken down and there's no use. So you can't give dopamine directly into the blood, into the body. So you have to give a precursor of the dopamine or a different format of dopamine which has to be broken down to dopamine in that particular part of the brain. So in the levodopa another, that is one of the drugs. So which what will it do? It has a capacity to cross the blood-brain barrier. நீங்க ஓரலா நீங்க மெடிசன் எடுத்து நீங்க நினைச்சுக்கோங்க அது ஸ்டமக்குள்ள போகும். ஸ்டமக்லேருந்து போய் இட் வில் ரீச் த பிளட் சர்க்குலேஷன். இந்த பிளட் சர்க்குலேஷன்லேருந்து பார்ட் ஆஃப் இட் வில் கிராஸ் ஓவர் ஃப்ரம் த பிளட் இன் டு த பிரெயின். இந்த பிரெயின்ல இட் வில் ரீச் த்ரூ த சிஎஸ்எஃப் அண்ட் இட் வில் ரீச் த சப்ஸ்டான்ஷியா நிக்ரா. அந்த ஏரியால அந்த நியூரான்ஸ் எடுத்துட்டு இட் வில் பிரேக் டவுன் இன் டு டோபமின். Unfortunately, when we are doing this kind of a drug delivery, we cannot actually predict how much of the part it is not a very specific delivery system. So if a tablet kuduthinga nichukongo and the only substantia nigra ku dhaan pohanu irukadu, it will go to the rest of the brain also, it will go to the rest of the body also. In the this levodopa will be broken down even in the blood, and the dopamine in the blood also will increase. So if increase ana enna agum amlin ketenga na blood la dopamine increase aachana, you can have nausea, you can have vomiting, you can have blood pressure can be dropped, you can feel giddy, you can feel faint because of the drop in the blood pressure. Brain la if it goes to other parts of the brain, then you can become more hyperactive, you can become aggressive because it produces that increased energy levels. So it is not a very specifically targeted medication. Next slide. Next slide. I will talk about it later on. Next slide. So adukosam enna pannamona, we have some medicines which can prevent the breakdown of dopamine in the blood, which is called as carbidopa or benzerazide. So in the carbidopa or benzerazide is combined with the levodopa and it is given in the as a tablet, so that it is not broken down in the blood and it goes into the brain. Edhukku solirukkena ipo ungalku, I'm sure a lot of people will be taking Sindopa eduthirukkeenga illaya, Sindopa or LCD or Tidomet. So there are two formulation of Sindopa and LCD or Tidomet. Normally are rendu formulation irukku in the low dose. One is like we call it as Sindopa 110 and Sindopa plus. So in the Sindopa and the reason why we give Sindopa 110 is Sindopa 110 la 100 milligrams of levodopa irukadhu, 10 milligrams of carbidopa irukadhu. Sindopa plus la 100 milligrams of levodopa and 25 milligrams of carbidopa. Carbidopa minimum quantity of 75 milligrams irukanum, so that none of the levodopa gets broken down in the blood and all of it can go into the brain. So Sindopa plus potinna, the chances that higher amount of blood levodopa goes into the brain, or Tidomet plus potinna, there is a higher chance that the brain will receive more levodopa because you are preventing the breakdown in the blood. Whereas if Sindopa 110 potinna, only small quantity of the Sindopa 110 will go into the brain. But what will happen is some part of the Sindopa will get broken down in the blood, and so you can have more chances of nausea, vomiting, hypotension if you're taking Sindopa 110. So dosing, yeah.
I'm sorry, since medication is very important for our members, what I'm going to do henceforth in this presentation is, I'm just going to paraphrase whatever you are saying. Right. So members will have better understanding and there will not be in any sort of doubt or confusion.
Sure.
So, I'm mute le edha vekka pore. Doctor enna solranga just or vaati repeat panna pore. So, I'm just going to repeat what doctor has said. So doctor, just correct me if I'm wrong. So you're saying levodopa's role is to cross the blood-brain barrier and to go into the brain, right?
Correct.
And then carbidopa, what does carbidopa do again?
Carbidopa prevents the breakdown of levodopa into dopamine in the blood.
In the blood, okay. So what doctor is saying is, so the levodopa is the main dopamine that you're getting, right? So for that to cross and go to your brain, they have developed it in such a way that it can cross the barrier and go. So that's why the levodopa dosage is always higher, carbidopa is lower. In Sindopa 110, which a lot of you take, there is a lesser dose of carbidopa. In Sindopa plus, there is 25 mg, no doctor, of carbidopa. That means
carbidopa.
Yeah. So that means that your levodopa, your dopamine is not getting into the blood directly, but is going to the brain. Hence, the dopamine has higher potency. It can work better. Oru vaati na Tamil la solliren. சிண்டோபா 110க்கும் சிண்டோபா பிளஸ்க்கும் என்ன வித்தியாசம்னா சிண்டோபா பிளஸ்ல நீங்க பாத்தீங்கன்னா கார்பிடோபா டோசேஜ் ஜாஸ்தியா இருக்கு. இப்போ உங்க டோபமைன் வந்து நிறைய உங்க பிளட்ல போயிடுச்சுன்னா டாக்டர் என்ன சொல்றாங்க, டோபமைன் பிளட்ல நிறைய வந்ததுன்னா வாமிட்டிங் சென்சேஷன் வருவான். அதே டோபமைன் லெவல் வந்து ரொம்ப பிரெயின்ல ஸ்ட்ரைட்டா போயிடுச்சுன்னா மூவ்மெண்ட்ஸ் ஜாஸ்தி ஆயிரும், லைக் யூல் ஹாவ் லாட் ஆஃப் இன்வாலன்ட்ரி மூவ்மெண்ட்ஸ். ஸோ த ட்ரிக் இஸ் இந்த ரெண்டையும் கரெக்டா பேலன்ஸ் பண்ணணும். சிண்டோபா பிளஸ்ல வந்து டைரக்டா வந்து டோபமைன் பிரெயினுக்கு நிறைய போற மாதிரி பிளட்ல கம்மியா கலக்கிற மாதிரி இருக்கும். அதே வந்து சிண்டோபா பிளஸ்ல பாத்தீங்க, சிண்டோபா 110 mg பாத்தீங்கன்னா பிளட்ல நிறைய கலக்கும். ஸோ மேபி தட்ஸ் வாட் ஷீ சேயிங், இஃப் யூ டேக் அ லாட் ஆஃப் சிண்டோபா 110 mg வாமிட்டிங் சென்சேஷன் ஜாஸ்தி ஆகிற சான்ஸ் இருக்குன்னு சொல்றாங்க. Anyway, I hope this is a little complicated, but I hope you're able to understand this. Sorry to interrupt, doctor. Please go ahead.
Yeah. I mean, it's also, if you have a lot more confusion, you can also have a lot more confusion. So if you are older and you're having confusion with Sindopa, we will usually prefer Sindopa 110.
Okay.
If your movements are short and you're not really happy with Sindopa 110, we will try with Sindopa Plus.
Okay, understood. Okay.
Yeah. So next slide. So as there's a lot of side effects with Sindopa. Na, konchem side effects irukum. One is that, as I told you, nausea, vomiting. You can have gastritis, burning sensation in the stomach. Sindopa typically Sindopa or Tidometless or whatever, levodopa has to be taken in empty stomach. You know, absorption is best with empty stomach. எம்டி ஸ்டமக்னா அட்லீஸ்ட் ஒரு ஹாஃப் அன் அவர் நீங்க டைம் கொடுக்கணும் டேப்லெட் போட்டுனதுக்கு அப்புறம் ஹாஃப் டு ஒன் அவர் பிஃபோர் யூ ஹேவ் எனி ஃபுட். பிகாஸ் ஒன்ஸ் யூ டேக் ஃபுட் இட் வில் ப்ரிவென்ட் தி அப்சார்ப்ஷன் ஆஃப் த டேப்லெட் அண்ட் தென் அந்த டேப்லெட் வில் ஜஸ்ட் கோ அப் இன் த ஸ்டூச் அண்ட் யூ வில் ஹேவ் நோ யூஸ் ஆஃப் த டேப்லெட். ஐடியலா யூ ஷுட் டேக் இட் இன் எம்டி ஸ்டமக், பட் சம் பீப்புள் ஹேவ் லாட் ஆஃப் வாமிட்டிங், நாசியா, கேஸ்ட்ரைட்டிஸ் இருந்தா வி டெல் தெம் டு டேக் அ வெரி ஸ்மால் குவாண்டிட்டி ஆஃப் ஃபுட் ஆர் மில்க் ஆர் சம்திங் டு prevent the gastritis and take this Sindopa. So again, tablet levodopa, Sindopa is actually a brand name. So Sindopa, Tidomet Plus or LCD, which are available, or Syncopone, or these are the tablets which are available. So you can, idu vandu neenga empty stomach la eduthukonga. Side effects paathinga, if you take high doses of Sindopa, you can have psychiatric problems like hallucinations, you can have BP drop, can have konjam thookam varalam, nariya perku thookam varum tablet potindadhukku apuram, and you can have gastritis. These are common side effects of most of the medicines. So once we finish off all the medicine, I will say which is maximum with what. Right. Shall we go to the next slide? Next slide.
I think this is also a video, so I'll go here.
No problem. Okay, so these are the tablets. Next slide. So if, next, again, back to the square one. Dopamine is reduced in the brain, so number dopamine kudutundu. So dopamine in the, there's a little more complicated explanations about these, is that the dopaminergic, in the dopamine another, actually it works on something called as a receptor. So dopamine and or it'll bind to one receptor on or a cup mari irukum, and the cup la poi it'll bind, and then it will start the signaling within the cell which is actually has that cup. So in the cup another is different at different parts of the brain. So we have something called as D1, D2, D3, D4, D5 receptors irukku. Levodopa, when you give, you can't actually predict where it will go and attach, but you can give some agonists which will only sit on specific types of cups. So specific areas are in the D2, D3 receptors, that is the most important areas, the pathway where there is a problem in Parkinson's disease actually involves D2 and D3 receptors. So you can actually specific on the D2, D3 mele okkara maari medicines tayar pannirukku. And the medicines, it will only sit on those areas. So these areas are present only present in the brain. So it does not cause any side effects in the blood. And even in the brain, it is present in particular part, only in the areas where the Parkinson's disease effect are important. It also sits in a little, to some extent, on other parts of the brain, but comparatively to, I mean, there are the, and the, in the receptor nala, you can have some problems, you can have some benefits. The main benefit being that it, these dopamine agonists, where agonist, it actually, it is not dopa, it's not pure levodopa, but it looks like dopamine, and it will go directly from the brain, blood into the brain. It will only go and work only in the brain. And in the brain, it will sit at particular, receptors, which are very important for Parkinson's disease treatment. The dopamine agonist is a huge group of medicines like pramipexole, ropinirole, roticotin. Idhukku munnadi we had, the newer drugs like apomorphine. Idella, they all form into one group called as dopamine agonists. So to rephrase or paraphrase it, dopamine agonists are drugs which look like dopa. They are not levodopa. They look like levodopa. They will go and sit in the receptor, which are required to stimulate the next in the line of the Parkinson's disease. And if a dopamine korchala irukku brain la or a particular area la, one way of treating it is you give dopamine from outside, which is what levodopa does. The next way is in the dopamine poi okkarra edathila, you put in one more medicine which will sit on that target. Okay, so that is dopamine agonist. Can we go to the next slide?
One quick summary of agonist, because I think a lot of members take these medications, a lot of agonists, and there's always like a confusion in this. There are questions on this. So doctor sonnadha na onnor vaati repeat pannirren. Ipa paarengla, in the agonist vandu dopamine, pure dopamine illa. This is not a pure dopamine medicine, but this helps dopamine medicine to act better. In a sense, in the marundu kudutha, brain la endha part la or edathil irundhu innor edathukku andha pathway irukko andha pathway la adu move aagradhukku the agonist help pannum. Idhu vandu or particular ah rendu receptors irukku appdin solranga, D2 and D3. Andha receptors dhaan nama movement alla control pannudhu, angu dhaan pathway irukku. So dopamine vandu poduva brain la appadi tappuna dump pannama andha valiya adu act pandrak help pandradhu agonist. So what agonist does is it helps your dopamine to move or to facilitate its receptivity in a particular pathway, which can help in facilitating our movement. That's what the agonists do. Please go on, doctor.
So I'm sure many of them must be on agonists. Hello?
Yeah, they are. They are on agonists.
So, yeah. So there are two types of agonists. Either one the olden and newer drugs either. Bromocriptine, glyceride, pergolide, they are called.
Doctor, you're breaking up a bit.
Just one second. Now the newer non-ergot-mediated agonists, which are ropinirole, pramipexole, and rotigotin. Apomorphine, but I'm just a koncham apna basic. So ropinirole is that Ropark tablet which you have, is one of the agonists. Pramipex is one of the agonists. Rotigotin and a patch. So it is not a tablet, but it is a patch where you can put it on your skin and over 24 hours and the medicine will just go through the subcutaneous tissue into the body, into the blood. The rotigotin patch is available at certain parts in the country. There was some problem initially when they made the rotigotin. We sweat a lot more and it's much more hotter than the Western countries. So there was a problem on the absorption through the skin, because once you start sweating and the patch line the correct medicine absorb aagudha illa theriyadhu. But even now, but they have come up with a new formulation which seems to be better than before. So the reason why I want you to tell is that normally, if it is possible, we don't usually combine render agonists, because agonists work at the same point. So either you are either on ropinirole or on pramipexole or on rotigotin. Normally, I tend to combine pannamato. So if you don't normally take pramipex and ropark together, unless there are like certain circumstances where you feel, okay, small dose of this and small dose of this might be better, and normally you actually take one of these medications. And most of them act in a similar manner. All three of them have a similar kind of treatment benefit, and all of them have a similar kind of side effect profile. Next. We are not using the previous, and the ergotamine dopamine agonist, we are not using because adhukku vandu heart problems vandu. So bromocriptinol, lisinopergolide, idella payishidu. Actually, if you have some 20-30 years back, these were the main drugs which are used. But they have developed and a cardiac valve fibrosis and a heart valve mala effect ahalan solli, we are not using it anymore. So we're only using non-ergotamine based dopamine agonist nowadays. Next. So the dose of dopamine agonist, usually you start very slow. You start, suppose if you will start on point, most of the drugs will start on 0.125 or 0.25 milligram 3 times a day, and increase panindu po. Pramipexole is maximum dose is 1.5 milligram 3 times a day. Ropark dose is around 8 milligram 3 times a day. So, and the mari increase panindu po. Again, the side effects of dopamine agonist, though it has got very little effect in the peripheral blood, you can still have nausea, vomiting. You can still have a BP drop. You can have, because it is more concentrated in the brain, sudden increase panna medicine, you can actually have confusion, you can have hallucinations, and you can have somnolence. In the thookam varudhu vandu, it's very, some people have very severe sleepiness with the dopamine agonist, especially ropark from pramipexole. Suddenly they may go into sleep, in which case you should not be driving a car. And then otherwise, you should probably reduce the medicine. These are the side effects which can happen with dopamine agonist. So if you have confusion or a hallucination or somnolence, normally we tend to avoid it or bring down the dose to as little as possible. Next, I think we've already talked about this. Next. The problem with dopamine agonists is, as I told you, D2, D3 receptors are supposed to be mostly involved in the movement, but they also have some psychiatric problems. The psychiatric problem is not like a typical psychiatric disease. It's called as impulse control disorders. This is very important because a lot of times what happens is patients don't tell about it, and unless you tell it to the doctor, they won't know. So increase paninde pohcha, it can cause a lot of havoc in your family life. So it is an impulse control disorder. Suppose you have an impulse. You will think about it twice, thrice. What I'm saying is taking decisions. Normally, we will think about it. We will see whether you will get a good outcome or a bad outcome. And then you will decide that, okay, illa way panitu correct. In the mari problem varala, problem irukala, you can have this much benefit in panitu. You will actually take some actions. But sometimes your brain in the dopamine agonist potenda, you tend to act on those impulses without thinking about what losses you can have. Common example and then gambling. Some people can just keep on gambling. Normally, everybody, I don't know whether anybody in this whole group gambles or not, but I'm sure that people, this is not something which is very common in Indian scenario. But Western scenario, there are a lot of casinos and they have a lot of gambling areas. And what they have found is, our ponana, they will keep on losing money, but they will not stop the gambling because they cannot stop. And the other start panana, they just become addicted to gambling. So they can have a lot of gambling. Similarly, they can sometimes have shopping, pathological. You can have excessive shopping. So in the excessive shopping, the patients who actually went and bought some, she just looked at makeup and she decided that she wanted to buy the makeup. My makeup over naal anju set vaayin vandutta. She bought some powder and she bought some, so many things she bought. And then she gave it to her maid saying that, because you're dark, you wear this makeup and it'll be better. The point was not that our maid kosam nenchindu vaangala. Because she bought it, she started distributing it to other people. The reason why she bought it is not, she also could not understand. She just could not stop buying it. This is called as compulsive shopping. Which is not at all essential. It is not like a normal shopping. Amala, everybody, I mean, women in general tend to shop a little bit more, but not like that. Like, not useful things also is something called as compulsive shopping. So these are all impulse control disorders. So one is gambling. The second thing is compulsive shopping. Third thing is you can have compulsive eating. If you just want to keep on eating, people can tend to eat a lot and put on more weight. And this is not like, they just want to eat it. It is not that they want, it's not like, you know, normal that you just have, okay, I want to eat a couple of mangoes in the mango season. So this is called as compulsive eating. So you can have compulsive eating, you can have compulsive shopping, gambling, which can happen. Something called as hypersexuality. This also I want to emphasize here, because this is something with Indian context to talk about sexuality is a lot of, there's a lot of taboo in it. But this can happen with dopamine agonists. Another time, situation, location, having sexual urges and asking their partners to have sex with them can happen with these dopamine agonists. And if it happens in older individuals, especially people who are 70s and 80s, it can bring a lot of problem to their wives and husbands. Sadanna engyo edathla is not bothering about whether they are in, their kids' house, whether there are people around. Sadanna and the urge varudhu, sexual urge varudhu, and to act on it. They can't stop acting on it. So these are side effects which can happen with dopamine agonists. There are two other things which can happen. One is called as funding. Funding is to keep on doing one task repeatedly. And suppose you have a table mala books, continuously. So that kind of thing can happen. Hobbyism can also happen. So these are side effects of dopamine agonists. They are not very severe. So this is important to know. Again, I'm emphasizing the fact, because this is the terinjada, you can bring it forward to your treating doctor, and then the doctor can say, okay, this is probably because of the medication, and bring it down. Lot of times in the side effects, asal yaar sollave maata, adu pathi pesavum maata, and it becomes a lot of problem. Suppose you have a lot of hypersexuality in the family, then there is a rift between the wife and the husband, and then it just keeps on increasing and you just ignore it. There is this kind of hypersexuality can also happen with other people in the family, and it may see. So the thing is that it may not just be with their wife or husband. They may try and do it with somebody else, and then it becomes a little problematic. This is the reason why I'm re-emphasizing it, is that I have come to realize that a lot of my patients had it, and a lot of them did not tell me about it. Till it was like quite late in their and some of them actually have gone back that they're getting divorced. So these are side effects of dopamine agonists, and you should know about it. They are all reversible. And I even then in a medicine korchonne, all of them will come down.
Thank you, doctor. Actually, this is very important. I cannot agree with doctor more when she says that we have to be very aware of these side effects, and we need to bring this to the attention of your doctor. In the agonists eduthukkaranaala, there is a lot of confusion that can cause in your mind. There can be a lot of hallucination. You can feel that somebody is talking to you, somebody is in the house, or your spouse is trying to cheat on you, or somebody is trying to rob you. And then you also tend to sleep a lot. Idella konja physical and emotional psychosis problems. Idha thavara behavioral problems la romba important vandu compulsive behavior. Either you gamble a lot or you have extraordinary urges for sexual intercourse. Idu vandu especially Indian context la nobody brings this up. In fact, in our support group meetings or when we have our own smaller meetings, none of our members brings this up, but I'm sure it is there. And then it is very good if you can talk about this to your doctor, because if they can alter the medication, then this behavior or this need can come down. See, doctor was saying it has gone to such an extent that marital problems, they started having a relationship outside the family, so that led to divorce. So to avoid such high social impact. If you can just alter your medication, then you know the problem could be controlled much sooner, and it is also an easily controllable problem. Thank you, doctor. I'm sorry to say we are running a little out of time because we have scheduled till 1. A lot of members, it will be medication time and lunch time. So let's quickly run through the other side effects, please.
So the other thing is that you can have dopamine dysregulation syndrome. And then medicine, even sirupayar kapri thar kad, medicine potukunum. So a lot of times you can have things like, okay, 1.5 hours I koche, and then tablet potukunum. That is also a part of the dopamine agonist. So they can over-medicate themselves because of this impulsive behavior. Kuncham, I'm feeling a little abnormal, so I need to take a medication. Next slide. So the other medicine, so okay, so now this is a diagram, if you can see it well. It is the levodopa, one on the dopamine, levodopa, so I've already told you that we have something called as dopa decarboxylase, which breaks it down to dopamine, and it is for that you give carbidopa along with levodopa. Apart from that, you also have something called as a COMT, catecholamethyl transferase, which also breaks down levodopa to small extent. So in a dosage of levodopa increase panicron, you can actually add on one more drug called as entacapone or tolcapone. Tolcapone is not being used, entacapone use panel. So syncapone and the group or entacom plus. There are these are drugs which will actually stop the breakdown of levodopa and increase the dosage, I mean duration of the action of levodopa. So syndopa ninga puttingo and the syndopa effect only or 2 hours. You want to increase the dose duration, you can add a tablet of entacom or entacom plus, or you can have syncapone. So which will increase the duration of levodopa. The other drug which, so these are what we call as peripherally acting drugs. And either on the brain, the levodopa dose increase panel. So without levodopa, giving carbidopa or entacom doesn't make sense. So whenever you take entacom, you have to take it with levodopa or syndopa, right? The second drug, so the classes of drug is, one, you give dopamine directly to reach the brain. You can give an agonist, which are called as dopamine agonist, or you can prevent the breakdown of dopamine in the brain. The third group of drug is called as MAOB inhibitors, just like selegiline or rasagiline, Razelecta, Celgene, Rasagin. These drugs prevent the breakdown of dopamine in the brain. So, ninga dopamine, Celgene or rasagiline, it will prevent the breakdown. So, these drugs can be given on its own because these are the drugs which actually prevent the breakdown of dopamine in the brain. So first thing, medicine start panache, most of the doctors would prefer to give you a breakdown inhibitor. And our selegiline or rasagiline is enough. You don't have to give dopamine in the initial part of the disease. As the disease progresses, you can give dopamine agonist and then you can give levodopa. Next slide.
Doctor, I have a small doubt here. So you're saying medicines like which breaks down the dopamine, is it rasagiline? Or what does it break down?
No, it does. It inhibits the breakdown of, and either breakdown is stop under the.
No, so you're saying that can be had without the dopamine itself, without levodopa.
MAOB inhibitors, MAOB inhibitors, and monoamine oxidase inhibitors.
Okay.
Which actually stops the breakdown of dopamine in the brain, that is Razelect or rasagiline or selegiline. Okay. Can be given in the initial periods where the dopamine levels are not very low in the brain.
Okay. By breaking down of dopamine, you mean whatever is being secreted in the brain, it kind of retains that level. So you don't have to give extra dopamine in form of levodopa, but if you give medicines like, say, Razelect, and if you're in the initial stage of PD, then the level of your dopamine in the brain is maintained.
Correct.
Okay, super. Thank you, doctor. Moving on to the next slide.
Yep. So, again, we will go to the next slide. I think we have done most of it. If you... Again, next slide. Right, next slide. So, in the moon drugs, rasagiline, selegiline, and cefenamide, which actually reduces the breakdown of dopamine. There is some suggestion that these medicines can actually slow down the progression of Parkinson's disease. It may have. I mean, it, again, this is doubtful. So most of the doctors prefer to give it in the initial periods of Parkinson's disease or give it as an add-on therapy with levodopa because they believe that it has got some disease protective effect. And the disease progress ahada paathukalam or effect irukkunnu solli they will give this in the beginning. So that is racetyline, seligiline or cefenamide. All of them again can cause confusion, hallucination, nausea, vomiting, hypotension. These are common side effects for any dopaminergic, any drug which is given for Parkinson's disease. Next. Yeah. So COMT also we have talked about. So this is entacapone. We'll go to next. Next. So this is just to show that there are two systems running in the brain. One is a dopaminergic system and one is called as a cholinergic system in Rikardha. The reason, so both of them are in a balance. So one way of treating Parkinson's disease is to increase the dopamine levels in the brain. The other way of treating the Parkinson's disease is to reduce the choline levels in the brain to balance it to the dopamine levels in the brain. In the choline levels in the brain can be reduced by something called as the pacitin or parkin, which is trihexyphenidylin in the medicine. Next. I'm sure many people must be taking it, pacitin or parkin.
Yeah.
Yeah, so this is, it has got a completely different mechanism. It has got nothing to do with the dopamine, but it's also symptomatic, where it balances the dopamine and cholinergic level. Both of them are in the same balance. So it's like if you, instead of increasing dopamine, you are actually reducing choline also to make it into a proper balance.
So choline, by cholinergic, you mean they are also some sort of chemical like dopamine?
Correct. This is a chemical which is called as acetylcholine. Okay. Again, it has got multiple actions.
Okay.
So we are reducing the choline production. There's a problem with reducing the choline production because actually choline, we are now making it suboptimal.
Mm.
It's not the optimal level as it is required in the brain. The choline is required for memory and it's required for sleep. And so when you reduce the choline levels in the brain, your memory and your other cognitive processes can go down. That's a major side effect. That is a
huge side effect. Okay. But why should, for Parkinson's, to maintain a level of dopamine, why should cholinergic... should they be reduced?
No, it may not. So the thing is that when you have it is like saying that if you have, it's like two wheels on a train.
Mm-hmm.
So if you are actually reducing the speed of one wheel,
okay.
The whole thing can topple off and can become slow, can come to a complete stop. Instead of that, if you reduce the speed on the other wheel also, the whole barrow will go a little slow, but it's not going to topple off.
Because dopamine is low, you're also reducing this to keep both in balance.
Correct. But okay. It does work a lot because I'm sure effect of parkin and pacitin, everybody must have seen in their, if you ask me clearly, how it works, it's a little complicated. We are still not sure. There are a lot of research going on why it should be like that. Okay. But it definitely has a major effect on tremor.
Tremors.
So if you have tremor predominant Parkinson's disease, if you give an anticholinergic, the tremor comes down quite markedly.
I see. So it helps in reducing tremors. Okay. So doctor, just quickly 5 minutes and we have to wrap up the presentation.
Sure. No, just that other thing is that side effects of cholinergic, anticholinergic is that it can cause dry mouth, which a lot of people have, and it can cause urinary retention. So these are two things, again, you should check if you are on pacitin. You can have increased constipation, you can have urine retention, and you can have dry mouth. These are things which you should know. The next drug is amantadine, which has got, a different type of treatment option. It reduces actually the dyskinesia. In the amantadine and trabletin. Okay, you will go to the next slide. We'll go to the next slide. I think I will. Then once that slide comes in, we can talk about it. So this is this is just a picture showing that how much does it reduce each medication, how effective it is. So if you see the effective dosage compared to, how much reduction happens in the off time. So it's around 2.3 hours. So it's around 0.6 to 2.3 hours courier off time in the medicine hour by its own. Next slide. So now, this is actually the normal levodopa number tablet. Next slide. We'll just go to the next slide. I'll put it up in the last slide.
Okay.
If you want to.
I know what
last one. Yeah,
you want this slide, right?
So this is actually epidi kadana. You can see the arrow going up and down, up and down, up and down. So these are the dopamine effects on the this is how the dopamine level fluctuates in the blood when you're giving dopamine from outside. So once in the first initial 4 years and adana, even though the dopamine level fluctuates, the whole period is green, which means that your improvement is quite marked with levodopa. Once it goes to the higher level, you start developing what is called as dyskinesias. So you, and the lower part, the gray part, where you don't even, if, and then the level when it comes down to lower part, you are not at all happy. So the green part is where you are happy. The lower part of the gray is where you are not. I mean, you are actually having still your off symptoms have not come down, are not improving. So once you cross it 4 to 7 years, once the level of the medication comes down, you will become off. And once the medicine goes up to a particular level, you become on. So the green part is on and the gray part is off. Once you cross even beyond that 7 to 10 years, you get something called as dyskinesias. In the red part is starter. So red part, in the medicine, if you see the arrow going up and down, tablet potuka the time, the white arrow, white line. So tablet potukata, you are in the lower part of the tablet. You are really off. You don't have, you're not able to move. Then for a short period, you are in the green where you are fine, you are actually on. Then you start developing extra moments, which is dyskinesias, just the jumping moment. Then again, you come back to a normal period where you are fairly on. And then you go off into off where your tremors increase and you are becoming more and more stiff. So in the fluctuations start, this is called as motor fluctuations. And dyskinesias start. If you go to the last part, like if you are more than 10 years, in the normal period, you recover. So tablet potukata, you will be off. Tamil potenda, you become very severely dyskinetic. So this is the problem with levodopa, giving levodopa. That's why the whole armamentarium of other medications has come in. This is because it's fluctuating like that. The tablet potenda, peak pohum, thirupin korin. Peak pohum, thirupin korin. So the medication is not, it's not, the line is not, the white line is not flat. Normally in the brain, it is a straight line. Not too much of fluctuations which happen. Whereas when you give the tablet, it has to go to one level, the brain le dopamine level jaasiyahum, thirupi koriyum, thirupi jaasiyahum, thirupi koriyum. Initial period, it is not a problem. Later on, you develop fluctuations where the koranjir podu, you are really very bad in your off state. And then you become on for some time, you are happy, and then you become off again. Then once it crosses a little beyond that, then you actually start developing extra moments when it crosses a level beyond. And if you go beyond, then you just fluctuate from off to dyskinesias. Next slide.
Yeah, I think this is a very good slide. I hope members take note of this. In the initial, so this chart pretty much says if you don't take any other medication but only levodopa, this is what happens, right, doctor?
Correct.
That's why we are giving you the whole host of other medication to reduce this sort of progression in Parkinson's. Because if you take only Sindopa, within like 10 years, it will stop acting very well. You'll have more of off times. And when you take the pill, there will be more dyskinesia. That's what she's saying. Okay. So
obviously after that, you can have other treatment options. So don't get disheartened. Even the point is that after 10 or 15 years of the disease, most of them would require levodopa and most of them will develop that kind of a dyskinesia and fluctuations. And you can have other treatment options like deep brain stimulation. Next slide. You can have something called an apomorphine pump, or you can have a levodopa pump. These are all therapies which actually tend to have a continuous stimulation rather than having a fluctuating stimulation like in medicines. Right? So we will stop at this. And you want, can I give you caveats of the, I mean, how the medicines are started? How much time can I take? 5 more minutes? Hello? Can I take 5 more minutes?
Hi. Yes, doctor. So, go ahead. Yeah.
So, if so when we give the treatment, first initial dopamine koncham dhaan korchala irukadnala brain le, especially for younger people who you need to take medicines for a long time, if you are less than 60 years of age, what we will do is we will start you on MAOB inhibitors, ana selgilin no rasagilin no start pannittu, we will see how you are responding to it. If you are okay with the rasagilin and selgilin for some time, you continue on the medicine. அதுக்கப்புறம் வி ஆட் அ லிட்டில் பிட் ஆஃப் டோபமின் அகோனிஸ்ட். டோபமின் அகோனிஸ்ட்னா பிராமிபெக்ஸோ ரோபினரோலோ இந்த மாதிரி ஆட் பண்ணும். ஸோ ஒன் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் யூ ஸ்டார்ட் ஆன் ராசலெக்ட் ஆர் செலஜிலின். ஆஃப்டர் 1 or 2 years, இஃப் யுவர் மூமெண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் நாட் சோ குட், தென் வி ஆட் டோபமின் அகோனிஸ்ட். இஃப் அகேன் ஆஃப்டர் தட் யூ ஆர் நாட் சோ குட், தென் வி ஸ்டார்ட் யூ ஆன் லிவோடோபா. யங் பீப்பிள் கேன் ஹாவ் டிஸ்கனீசியாஸ் மோர், அண்ட் பிகாஸ் 10 years டிசீஸ் டியூரேஷன் ஜாஸ்தி தான், யூ தே வில் பி டேக்கிங் மெடிக்கேஷன்னால வி ப்ரிஃபரபலி டோன்ட் ஸ்டார்ட் ஆன் லிவோடோபா இன் த இனிஷியல் பீரியட். So we start on MAOB inhibitors, then we start on dopamine agonists, then we start on levodopa, and then we add on things like entacapone or tolcapone or things like apomorphine pump. Older people, these medicines can cause more side effects. So younger people tolerate dopamine agonists and MAOB inhibitors or pacitan much better than older people. Older people, suppose if I give any medicine, in my behavioral changes can happen more frequently in older. So 60 years ku mela irukravalukku, lot of doctors will prefer to start the patient on levodopa only, because that is the least drug which can cause behavioral side effects. So behavioral side effects irukadu, confusion, hallucinations irukadu. Hallucinations are na, you can have some if you have a high dose of dopamine in any of these forms, you can have what is called as hallucinations. Hallucination is suddenly yaro irukra mari and yaro vandutu pona mari, you can have feeling like that, which can happen with any of the medication. It is not a disease related effect, it is a side effect of the medicine. Sometimes rarely when your disease is very long standing, you can have a disease mediated effect, but most of the times if you have a hallucination, yaro vandutu pona mari and yaro and the general lane yaro paathirukra mari வந்து அடிக்கிற மாதிரி அந்த மாதிரி ஃபீலிங் ஏதாவது இருந்ததுன்னா, தட் இஸ் ஆல் மோஸ்ட்லி ரிலேட்டட் டு மெடிசன். மோஸ்ட் காமன் மெடிசன் விச் கேன் காஸ் திஸ் இஸ் அமான்டிடீன் ஆர் பாசிடேன். அதுக்கப்புறம் யூ கேன் ஹாவ் இட் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் பிராமிபெக்ஸோல் ஆர் ரோபினரோல், அண்ட் த லீஸ்ட் லைக்லி டு ஹாவ் இட் இஸ் லிவோடோபா. திஸ் இஸ் மோர் லைக்லி இன் ஓல்டர் இண்டிவிஜுவல்ஸ். 60 ஜாஸ்தியானா ஆல்ரெடி பிரெயின் ரிசர்வ் குறைச்சலாக இருக்கிறதுனால அவளுக்கு தே ஆர் மோர் ப்ரோன் டு டெவலப்பிங் ஹாலுசினேஷன். ஸோ வி ஸ்டார்ட் ஆன் லிவோடோபா. In case that you develop hallucinations, you again, we will modify the medicine accordingly to make sure that you're better. Okay.
Okay, doctor. I think that was good. That was also very important. I hope you all understood what doctor was saying here in the last couple of minutes. Very important point, because it all depends on at what age you develop Parkinson's. If you develop at a very younger age, say lesser than 60, they'll immediately not start you off on a levodopa. They will give you medicines like pacitan and parkin, and then they'll add agonist, and then they'll add levodopa. But if you're affected after 60, say, they might straight away start you off on levodopa and not give you too much agonist. In the agonist kudutha, it can cause a lot of hallucination and psychosis issues and behavioral issues. So to avoid behavioral and psychosis issues in older generation or older segment of population, they do not do that.